So Pablo, Tony, yesterday he was not willing to make some strange questions after the talk. So I trust you. I really trust you. So, here we go. Thanks for the invitations. So, my Alzados Aerolino, for the mild Alzados, my first option will be, and let me show you this technique, the tempus and percutaneous intraarticular chevron ceremony, plus a percutaneous adductor tendon release. This would be my first option. The second one would be a retention, but these I've done this with patients over 65 years, so there is some bone loss, cosmetic indications, and some ulcers, and etc. So this idea is also a percutaneous adductor tendon release. When I have an ulcer DNA, I can do a triplanar vessel. Then I can have a monoga, and it can serve me when it's an evidence of that ulcer. So I'll talk about a little about this technique. It's a intraarticular percutaneous chevron. I began this in 2014. The indication would be mild to moderate alveolar. It consists on 5 steps and 3 portals. And then nowadays I've done 102 feet. What's the evolution of this technique? We have some radiographic validation. Dr. Kilby knows they are here, but they know this is true. And then we have some safety and security validation that was published on Radical International. So I will show the actual some data about this. And then the clinical study is in progress. So talking about the technique, this would be the step one, the port up to portal one. You need a 2 mm K wire for displacement. The P1 you can see with the fluoroscopy. This portal is in the limit between proximal third and middle third of the first empty first metaphorical set head. So you need a dorsal medial and also dorsal capsulotomy because you can lose fracture. Because it's a intraarticular technique, the capsule with track the metaphorical head over and even without correction. So in adverse cases, that's why I leave this technique for several years. Six or seven years ago, because I didn't done dorsal medial and dorsal capsulotomy. Now, when I'm doing this, I'm not using correction anymore. So, it's a bicorsal ceremony, perpendicular, it's vertical and horizontal. There is a vertical and horizontal limb orientation. I've done this with a patient straight through chamber. The ideal degree would be 90, but the truth would be that is when we see the sagittal rate that is between 80 and 100 degrees. This is the displacement. We use the Bosch method. I know there are some devices to make this displacement, but we used to, because we have done a lot of Bosch techniques, second generation techniques, so it's easy for us to make this kind of displacement. This would be the step three up to portal two. The fixation is another portal. It's a little bit proximal and dorsal to first portal. The direction of the stabilization would be from dorsal medial to lateral plantar direction. It would increase on the surface and finish. So this step four, portal up to portal two. This is the residual proximal bony resection. We have to do this with a wedge for 3.1. This is a step five, this is the lateral release, that is the percutaneous and filter tendon release. This is, we done this with the first one space portal, and we do the adductor tendon and the capsule plantar release. This is the second step, when you turn around 90 degrees to try to reach the adductor tendon. This is one of the cases. To show you some mild deformity. This is the result. You can see on the AP view and on the sagittal view the correction. This is another case also with the correction with the three portals. We've done at least a very study that I showed you before. I will talk about only the most dangerous portal would be the two, because it's near the dorsal medial, dorsal nerve. This average 4.1 millimeters, so it's near this level. That would be aware of. So, from other Aristotelians, I will do also a petro if you need a displacement of less than 50%. I will do a meta if you need a displacement more than 50%. Assuredly, we are pertaining to the expert under release, plus or minus an 18 as well. Also pertaining. This is one of the meta cases, so I will talk about this later. And this is our Argentinian kind of meta, because the first screw is not going out and then going in. But Joel told me that this is a meta also. So I say it's Argentinian meta. For severe cases, my first option would be I will extend the indication for distal cervix. We will do a meta plus a tendon, aggressive tendon release, plus an ATM surgery, and the second option would be a basal surgery plus a retention, a double surgery, plus or minus a doctor release. So, which index we use the most would be 70% for pecto, 23% for mica, 5% only for retention. First, the basal basal surgery 2%, the lateral release, a doctor of always the whole cases, and ATM surgery 25%. My learning curve for this osteotomy will be more than 50 cases. I know that lateral release or DNO or maybe osteotomy will be less than 20, but this technique is very, I think it's very difficult to begin. So the total complication rate would be 5.2%. These are some of the complications. You can see the picture at the bottom. This guy is, we say, Jorge Pinto. I don't know what his name in English, but it's a break. What is happening? So you can see the blade, the rupture of the blade, you have to take this out. And then loss of correction, I think this would be the distal arm, the horizontal arm is too long, and then the fixation was too medium, and then we lose some correction. And then we have this 24 patient with a malunion, because they have rotated drafts. So, thank you, Pablo, for trying to do this. You must do this on your part, but anyway, I will do it. Have the generation seen my approach? For allergic rigidus grade 1, I will be only a dorsalectomy plus a reduction lateral release. For grade rigidus 2 and 3, I will do a shortening papers, it's the same technique, but you have to change your stabilization. It's like a perf stabilization, like I meant to do always. So the P2 will be different, it's a dorsal meter or a dorsal lateral to the extensor tendon. So conclusions. Nowadays, we have higher quality studies supporting MIS surgery, three generation techniques, reliable limits, the open procedure, and that's with all these known features, and it seems that it doesn't reproduce its disadvantages in complications. Surely, MIS surgery has extensive learning curve. I didn't know the kind of this study, but I think it's not really published yet. Despite this, prospective study, larger regulation, and long-term follow-up are needed to achieve to definite conclusions in the best search for treatment option for MIS. So, I don't know if is this picture the future, but maybe. You can see me on the ground. It's looking like, what is Joel doing here? San Comita. This is a 5-year-old picture, and Paula is laughing. So it seems the future, but I don't know it. Thanks.